वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द सीरीज ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ बायोलॉजी क्लास 12. अगेन वी आर हियर विद लेसन नंबर 2 दैट इज सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द मेगास्पोर मेगास्पोरेंजियम. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मूव अहेड विद द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेगास्पोरोजेनेसिस. Megasporogenesis. When we are talking about megasporogenesis, again, as the word indicates, megasporo. Megasporo means it is derived from the word megaspores, and genesis means to produce. And what are megaspores? Megaspores are the female gametes or female gametophytes. So it is a process of formation of the female gamete from a single megaspore mother cell present in the micropylar region of the nucellus. So defining it, it is a process of development of megaspore or female gamete from a single megaspore mother cell, that is MMC, at the micropylar region in the nucellus. So this is the definition of megasporogenesis, that it is the process of development of a megaspore or the female gamete from a single megaspore mother cell, that is MMC, at the micropylar region in the nucellus. Yesterday we have talked about the structure of the microsporangium, and we all very well know what the megasporangium looks like. Now, how does this process take place? As I've already told you all, that this process occurs at the micropylar region in a single cell within the nucellus. So what happens, this single cell, it is abundant, it is quite large in structure, and it is rich, or it is containing abundant or dense cytoplasm containing a single nucleus. This is the nucleus, and this is the MMC, that is the megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell, then it undergoes meiosis, and it produces a dyad. Producing two cells. Then later on, again, as we all know, that meiosis is a two-step procedure, that is, it is going to undergo again meiosis first and meiosis second. And as a result of what? As a result of this, a tetrad will be formed. 2, 3, four. And these are the nucellar cells. So now this is a dyad stage and this is the tetrad stage. Up till here, again, as we all know, that the resultant of meiosis is production of the four haploid cells. Now what is important to hear is that in the process of the formation of the female gametophyte, that is the embryo sac or the ovule, what happens? Out of the four haploid cells that are formed, only one is functional and the rest three of them degenerates. That is, these three, they are going to degenerate and only one of them, it is going to become functional. So the next procedure that takes place is, from the tetrad only one of it remains functional and the rest three degenerate. Now this is the actual position of the cell that has become functional in nature. Now this single cell, it undergoes mitosis. And it produces two nucleus. The nucleus undergoes mitosis, not the cells. The nucleus undergoes mitosis and it produces two nucleuses and cell wall formation doesn't take place. Then again, leading to mitosis, a stage is reached where what happens? Four nucleuses are produced without the cell wall formation taking place. Again, mitosis will occur and a stage is reached where eight nucleus without the cell wall being laid between them is formed. That is, we are containing over here a single cell which contains eight nucleus. Now this this cell, it is going to undergo arrangement of cells, that is transformation into the mature embryo sac. What happens now? That out of the eight nucleuses that are formed, these nucleuses migrate to their respective places. So out of the eight, three of them move towards the chalazal end or the chalazal pole, three of them move towards the micropylar end or the micropylar pole, and two of them remain at the center. After this arrangement of the nucleus, cell wall starts being laid between them. That is, now you can see that after the cell wall is being laid down between these nucleuses, that three cells are present at the micropylar end, three cells are present at the chalazal end, and a single large size central cell is present at the center containing two nucleuses. So this is the chalazal and all these three, these are termed as antipodal cells or antipodals. Here at the, this is the end is known as the micropylar end. And out of the three, one is known as the egg or the ovule. And the rest two cells, they are said to be the synergids. The two synergids along with the ovule, they form the एग एपरेटस एंड रिमेनिंग सेंट्रल लास्ट साइज सेल, दिस इज द सेंट्रल सेल विच कंटेन्स टू न्यूक्लियस. दीज टू न्यूक्लियसेस, दीज आर सेड टू बी द पोलर न्यूक्लियाई. Now we have attained the stage which is known as 8 nucleate 7 celled stage, that is the embryo sac which is formed from a single megaspore mother cell has led to the development of an embryo sac containing 8 nucleate 7 cell stage. How? We can very easily see that how many nucleuses are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3 at the chalazal end, 3 at the micropylar end, 2 at the center. Means we are having 8 nucleuses. And how many cells we are having? 3 at the chalazal end and 3 at the micropylar end, that is 6, and 1 central last size cell. This is leading to a sum up of 7 cells. So we are having in all 7 cells and 8 nucleuses in the embryo sac, which is a characteristic feature of the angiosperm. And this very process of formation of this embryo sac or the female gametophyte from a single megaspore mother cell is known as monosporic development. Now these cells, they have got varied roles. As we are going to look ahead, this egg apparatus which is present at the micropylar end, this is going to take place in actual fertilization event. That is, the egg, it is going to form the embryo pore proper, and the two synergids, they are going to guide up the way or the pathway to the pollen tube. Then talking about the two central nucleuses, these two polar nuclei, they are going to result in the formation of the endosperm due to triple fusion. Then these antibodals, they again help in the varied events of embryo development. So here we have talked about the process of formation of the megaspore from a single megaspore mother cell, and this is known as the monosporic development. And we have reached up to the 8 nucleate 7 cell stage, which is a very characteristic feature which will be very very essential, and which is very essential for the double fertilization events taking place in all the angiospermic plants. So now we are going to move ahead as we have completed up with the first phase of fertilization, pre-fertilization event, that is the development of the gametes. Now we are going to talk about the transfer of the gametes. As we all know that the gametes need to be transferred towards one another, so as the process of fusion of the male gamete with the female gamete can very easily take place. So now in the next class we are going to talk about the transfer of gametes. Thank you.